Hi everyone and welcome to the new video. Today I want to answer a fun question that I saw online: are phones radioactive? This may sound stupid at the first glance, but as we know, there are no stupid questions, they can be only stupid answers, so let's figure it out. And to answer the question, I will use my phone, I will use a radiation detector, and I will use an IRCI detector that can detect ionizing and non-ionizing radiation. For the comparison of the radiation level, I will also use a real piece of the uranium ore. It can be fun, let's get into it. First, let's figure out what types of radiation exist in nature, and the answer is not so easy. Generally, there are two types of radiation: ionizing radiation and non-ionizing radiation, and they are completely different. What is ionizing radiation? Ionizing radiation is a radiation that has enough energy to change the atoms, to ionize them. And this is the type of radiation most of people think about, like atomic bomb or Chernobyl or Fukushima. And by the way, ionizing radiation is not always dangerous. For example, during the flight, because of cosmic radiation, you have a radiation level about 10 times more than on the ground. And there is also a background radiation level that is never zero, and we can see it on the Geiger counter. And finally, another big type of radiation is non-ionizing radiation. There are different types of radiation here, like radio waves, sunlight, infrared, and some others. And this radiation is non-ionizing, so it cannot change our atoms. A non-ionizing radiation can be damaging with a high intensity. For example, microwaves can make the water boil. However, it doesn't ionize the atoms, and with a low intensity, it's mostly harmless. And now let's do an experiment and let's see what kind of radiation the phone can produce. Okay, let's start the experiment, and as a first test I will show how the real ionizing radiation looks like with the uranium ore. This piece of uraninite is highly radioactive and we can see it on the radiation detector. It is a classical ionizing radiation. It was known since the beginning of the 20th century, and even Marie Curie used uraninite in her experiments. And how about the smartphone? Let's do a second test, and as we can see, the result is nothing. We see only the background radiation, the same level as normal, and nothing happens. However, it's not the end of the video, let's check the non-ionizing radiation. Here I have an IRCI detector that can detect both ionizing and non-ionizing radiation. And as we can see, the result is interesting. At the top of the screen we can see the ionizing radiation, at its level it's normal. And at the bottom of the screen we can see non-ionizing electromagnetic radiation, and here we can see some activity. And obviously without radio waves the phone will not be able to send and receive data. If we want to avoid it, the only alternative way is to use the old rotary phone with the cord. Just for fun I will put a piece of uraninite nearby, and we can see that the level of ionizing radiation is increasing, but the phone itself is not generating any ionizing radiation on its own. So, let's answer the final question. Is your smartphone radioactive? If we are talking about the ionizing radiation, like in the case of Fukushima or Chernobyl, the answer is no. But if we are talking about non-ionizing radiation, then the answer is yes. Your phone is generating radio waves, which are important to send and receive data. Without them, the phone will not work. And this level is safe and it's not dangerous, so enjoy your phone. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something new. In the next video, I will show the radiation measurements in more details. Stay tuned and see you next time.